Good morning, my brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome back to JPCE, Spiritual Talk, Jerry Campbell. So this morning's devotional, Return to God, a small reading from Zechariah chapter 1, verse 3. But before we get into our devotional, we're going to ask the Lord in a quick prayer. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Because we're going to ask the Lord to shine to our hearts, O loving Master, the pure light of your divine knowledge. And open the eyes of our mind, that we may understand your teachings in Scripture. Help us to apply what we learn, such as having conquered sinful desires. We may pursue a spiritual way of life, thinking and doing all things that are pleasing to you. For Christ, your God, you are light, and to you we give glory. Father, Son, Holy Spirit, both now and forever, with sages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heavens, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses. Do you forgive those who trespass against us? And lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom, the power, the glory of the Father, and the Son, Holy Spirit, both now and forever, the sages. Amen. The Lord is our shepherd. All right, good morning. Welcome back. So grace is faithfulness. Indeed, the spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. So return to God. Zechariah chapter 1. Verse 3, being the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. So tell the people, this is what the Lord of hosts says. Return to me. This is the declaration of the Lord of hosts. And I will return to you, says the Lord of hosts. Being the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. So God places much of the burden of what we will become on our response to him. If we have drifted from God, his call is to return to him. God promised that if we will return, he will immediately renew his relationship with us. James chapter 4, verse 8 promises that if we draw near to God, he will draw near to us. Matthew chapter 7, verse 7 guarantees that if we seek Christ, we'll find him. Much of the Christian life rests upon our response and our desire to experience God to the fullest. Why is it that some Christians seem to go much deeper in their walk with God than others? Why have some had such powerful intercessory prayer ministries that have changed the course of nations? Why has God chosen to anoint the words of some so that when they speak or pray or preach, it is obvious that their words are consecrated by God? It is because these individuals have committed themselves to pursue God until his presence is powerfully real in their lives. They've decided to settle for nothing less than a vibrant relationship with God, and he has honored their desire. Have you become complacent in your relationship with God? Or are you hungering for more? Don't become satisfied with a relationship with God that is broken by sin and void of the power of the Holy Spirit. If you have just as much as God's power presence available to you as the greatest saint in Christian history, return to God. There's so much more in the store for you if you will return to him. He awaits your response. In the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Beautiful read, beautiful reflection.
It's true.
So when we see in Zechariah, right, in chapter 1, verse 3, let's read it again. I'm going to read from my Orthodox Study Bible. It says, and you shall say to them, thus says the Lord Almighty, return to me, and I will return to you, says the Lord. Right? It's a little bit different version than without the devotional. So what we see here, right, is that Zechariah is delivering what the same message, right? So the prophet Zechariah is delivering the same message of repentance later preached by Christ himself. Repentance is necessary for salvation. That's what it's saying. There is no right relationship with God without turning from sin to God. Okay? So in order for us to have salvation, we must repent. It's all about we must repent. Forgiveness of sins, getting and receiving God's mercy. Right? Jesus preached the same thing. Right? All must repent or perish. Right? For us to draw closer to God is our responsibility. Right? If we want to feel closer to him, then we must make every effort to be closer to him, if that makes sense. Serving our Lord is discipline. It's obedience, self-denial, and never forget struggle. Because without struggle, there is no deification, right? Meaning, How can one draw closer to God if there is no struggle? Many Christians do not understand struggle is part of our faith. It's part of the endurance of our faith. And this is where we'll end this morning. Remember what we just read about salvation. You must come to full repentance, right? To receive salvation. You must turn from those wicked ways, right? And walk a path of righteousness, right? Living a blameless life in Christ without reproach, right? In Christ's name, right? That's all I have this morning. Thank you all so much. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Oh Lord, guide us, moment us your divine saving words. You illuminate the souls of sinners to comprehend what we just read. That we don't appear simply as hearers spiritual words, but doers of good deeds, true pursuers of faith, having a blameless life and conduct without reproach in Christ our Lord. And to you, you are light. We give glory. Father, Son, Holy Spirit, both now and forever, endless ages. Amen. Our Father who art in heavens, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, to forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom, the power, the glory of the Father, and the Son, Holy Spirit, both now and forever, the sages. Amen. The Lord is our shepherd. We depart peace. In the name of the Lord, my brothers and sisters in Christ. Peace be with you all. Go in peace. Shalom, shalom. May the Lord forgive those who love us and those who hate us. Right? May the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be merciful to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and forever. Sages. Amen. Jerry Wesley Campbell, good morning, good day, good afternoon, good evening, good night, whenever and however these messages find you all. I love you all so much. JPCE, spiritual talk, never hold back, no excuses. Right? Build that relationship with your Creator. Right? You do good, shun evil. Right? But remember, the key to salvation is through repentance. It's forgiveness. Receiving of God's mercy, right? I love you all so much.